So that's our first example. We'll continue and look at a different one. Lunches, branches, interviews by the pool, considered a fool because I dropped out of high school. Stereotypes of a black male, misunderstood, and it's all good. You can also identify the rhyme in those words. Pool, school, misunderstood, and good. Understand? Pool, school, misunderstood, and good. One thing I would like you to bear in mind is that you look at the vowel sound in the last syllable of a word. Bear that in mind. That is the most important part. If you can get that one, you will never miss a question on rhyme. Not that. Not. We look at the vowel sound in the last syllable of the last word, the line. Always look at the last syllable, the last vowel sound, the vowel sound in the last syllable. It will help you understand the rhyme. Cut and fight do not rhyme. Might and come do not rhyme. Hope it together. Cut and fight do not rhyme. Might and come do not rhyme. Might rhymes with fight. Are you together? Look at the vowel sound, not the letter. So someone might look at cut, fight, you go for that TT at the end. No, that's not rhyme. Might rhymes with fight. The sound, we're looking at the sound. Cut rhymes with mat. We look at the sound, not the letter. So if you get that concept, you will understand rhyme. If you get the concept that I will look for the sound in the words and not the letters in the word, then you're good to go when it comes to rhyme. Now let's look at an example of KCSE 2012, paper 1, to demonstrate rhyme. They're saying, identify any two pairs of rhyming words in the above poem. Look at that poem. If we must die. If we must die, let it not be like hogs, hounded and penned in an ignorant spot, while round us bark the mad and hungry dogs, making their mock at our ancestors, at our cast lot. If you must die, oh, let us nobly die, so that our precious blood may not be shed in vain. Then even the monsters we defy shall be constrained to honor us through dead. All kinsmen, we must meet the common foe. Though far outnumbered, let us show as brave. And for their hounded bows deals one death blow. What thought, therefore, lies in the open grave? I like men who will face the murderer's cowardly pick, pressed to the wall, dying but fighting back. Take your time, look at that poem titled If You Must Die by Claude McKay. That poem was set in KCSE 2012, paper 1 of KCSE 2012. Let's look at that poem. Let's interrogate that poem. Let's analyze that poem. Then come up with pairs of rhyming words from that poem. I just list them down, then you post online. I will go through and mark them. Then I'll guide you on where the rhyme is and where there's no rhyme. One thing that you must bear in mind is like you're looking for the sound in the words, not the letters. We are looking at the sound. Secondly, bear in mind that we look at the vowel sound in the last word, last syllable of the word. We look at the vowel sound in the last syllable of the words. Rhyme scheme. Let's go further. Sorry. Let's look at rhyme scheme. After understanding rhyme, we now want to understand what is a rhyme scheme. And we all know that this is a very important area of paper 1 English. All the poems that are tested in paper 1, they test on the rhyme scheme. So I want us to understand what is a rhyme scheme. Now, simply, a rhyme scheme is a pattern of sounds that repeat at the end of a line of a poem. It is a pattern of sounds that repeat at the end of a line of a poem. The patterns are encoded by letters of the alphabet. Lines are designated with the same letter, rhyme with each other. For example, the rhyme scheme ABAB shows that line 1 rhymes with line 3, while line 2 rhymes with line 4, because you have assigned them letters A, B, A, B. So simply, the patterns are normally encoded by letters of the alphabet. Lines are designated with the same letter rhyme with each other. And I've given you an example there. I shall take in detail of what that means. Look at this example. Under the tree, she sat silently watching the river. She saw a dog chasing a cat. The sight of that gave her a shiver. Under the tree, she sat. We assign that letter A. Silently watching the river. So the first one is sat, we put A. The second line, the last word is river. It does not rhyme with sat, the last word in the first line. So we assign that B. She saw a dog chasing a cat. Cat rhymes with the sat in the first line. So we come back and say, and give, we assign A to cat. Then the sight of that gave her a shiver. Shiver rhymes with river. So we assign them the same letter, B, B. Then sat rhymes with cat, we assign that A, A. Sat rhymes with cat, so we assign letters A to them. River rhymes with shiver, so we assign letter B to them. Hope that is understood. We just assign a letter to the last word as we go on. Let's go further and see. The rhyme scheme is A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, E, F, G, G. Note, in the poem Die rhymes with defy, and fall rhymes with death blow. Try saying the words aloud. Just try. Try to pronounce those words aloud. The words die and defy have the same sound. Die, defy, I. If you pronounce them, die, defy. That letter is written as AI in the phonetic alphabet. That will be something like that. Now, while fall and death blow have the same sound, O, fall, blow, fall, blow, they both rhyme. So that is the pattern for the poem You Must Die. Now there are two types of rhyme schemes in a poem. We have the regular rhyme scheme and the irregular rhyme scheme. Basically, the regular rhyme scheme is a rhyme scheme that has a predictable pattern. The irregular rhyme scheme is a rhyme scheme that cannot be predicted. It does not have a predictable pattern. So those are the two types of rhymes that you have in English. regular rhyme scheme. The poem has a constant, definite pattern, or the rhyme can be predictable. That's why I call it a regular rhyme scheme. If the poem, If You Must Die, has a regular rhyme scheme, A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, E, F, you can predict A, B, A, B, C, D, C, D, E, F, you can predict what will come next. So definitely that becomes a regular rhyme scheme. Irregular rhyme scheme, now in this one, a poem has an uneven pattern, unpredictable pattern. You cannot predict the pattern to tell the next rhyme. That's what we call it irregular. You cannot predict what will come next. For example, if you have a rhyme scheme like A, B, C, A, D, E, F, D, A, it is irregular. You cannot predict what will come next. So that's why we call it an irregular pattern. So there are two types of rhyme schemes, regular and irregular. Regular, it has a predictable pattern. Irregular has an predictable pattern. Look at that poem, If You Must Die. Let's try to identify the rhyme scheme in that poem. We have hogs, spots, dogs, lots, die, shed, defy, dead, foe, brave, blow, grave, pack, back. Consider the last words of the lines, the last word of each line. Then you assign them letters up to the last one. You realize the same pattern I've given you just before. That one there is the rhyme scheme of that poem. Now, when describing the rhyme scheme of a given poem, one, identify the rhyming words in the poem. Assign each rhyme a letter of the alphabet starting with A. Go all the way to the last line. Do not add more letters after the last line, even if the pattern is predictable. When you've been told to identify the rhyme scheme in a poem, just follow, stick to what you've been given. Do not go further and add a letter to maybe a fifth line, seventh line that is not in the poem. Just stick to what you've been given. Then write down the pattern A, B, A, B, or A, B, B, A, something. Then state whether the rhyme scheme is regular or irregular. So you must give the examiner all the formula. Show him how you identify that rhyme scheme. Then write it down neatly. Then tell the examiner down that it is a regular rhyme scheme because it has a predictable pattern, or it is an irregular rhyme scheme because the pattern is unpredictable. I have some few questions there. Sample KCC questions, 2018. Paper 1, 2018 is there. A poison tree, look at that poem. That is assignment for you. Read the poem below and then answer the questions that follow. But for now, I want you to stick to rhyme scheme. Identify the pattern in those poems and tell me whether it's regular or irregular. KCSE 2016. Describe the rhyme scheme of the poem and explain its function. The giraffe. Look at that poem called The Giraffe from a KCSE paper. Identify the rhyme scheme in that poem. Tell me whether it's regular or irregular. So try and attempt those questions. Then let's link up online in a Google Classroom. Let's communicate further. Bring your questions. I'll have time to respond to all of them. Then attempt this work. I'll mark and direct you further on rhyme scheme. I want by the end of this session, you should all be competent with rhyme scheme. You should never fail a question on rhyme scheme because they're actually simple things. Once you follow the rules, you'll never have a problem with rhyme scheme. Otherwise, for now, stay safe. Kindly sanitize your hands, observe social distance, and you shall win this battle. Thank you very much. See you later.